A simple water-based Rankine cycle operates between 6 megapascals and 75 kilopascals. The temperature at the turbine entrance is 500 degrees Celsius. The turbine has an isentropic efficiency of 93%, and it is assumed that there are no losses at the pump. The water leaving the condenser is subcooled by 11.76 degrees Celsius. Draw a TS diagram of this cycle, including the temperature values for all four states. You can leave the specific entropy values as variables. As usual, try pausing here for a minute and solve this yourself before watching the solution up next. This is the third example for the Rankine Cycle main lecture. The link to that 10-minute lecture and the links to all the other lectures of the thermo course are found in the description below. Since we have both pressure values, we can draw two isobaric lines on our TS diagram first. And after this, we basically want to find all four temperatures and locate all four states with respect to the saturation dome. We're being told that the water is at a subcooled state after leaving the condenser. This just means that the final temperature of the water at state 1 is 11.76 degrees lower than the saturation temperature for the condenser's pressure. Still on the same constant pressure line that the condenser operates at. So we look up the saturation pressure at 75 kilopascals, and we find it to be 91.76 degrees Celsius. This means that T1 is 80 degrees Celsius. From 1 to 2, we go straight up, as there is no mention of the isentropic efficiency of the pump, and we're told that there are almost no losses there. Since the work of the pump is both V times P2 minus P1 and H2 minus H1, we can solve for H2, so that we can find the temperature it corresponds to. The value for V1 is approximated as the specific volume for a saturated liquid at T1, following what we learned about compressed liquids, link below, just as H1 is approximated as HF for T1. Here we could use the longer and more precise expression, but the number is not going to change much for the purposes of the TS diagram. After substituting these values and finding H2, we can find T2 because since 2 is a compressed liquid, our approximation says H2 should be HF for that temperature. In other words, we're looking for a temperature for which HF is the H2 value. We look at the tables and find that we have to interpolate between these two enthalpy values to find a temperature. With this value for T2, we see what I was pointing out in the main lecture video, that the difference between T1 and T2 is very small. This is of course expected, as the pump is indeed increasing the energy of the liquid, but not its temperature. Now T3 was given to us, and at this pressure and this temperature, the water is superheated. So we know where to draw state 3, and we can copy the entropy value. This is important because we'll need S4S to figure out where state 4S is. Now all we're doing here is drawing at the TS diagram, and we are asked not to find specific entropy values. But if you want to see that process, make sure to check out one of the examples linked below. For this problem, all we need to see is that at P4, SF is lower than S4S, lower than SG. And this means that state 4S is a saturated mixture. Now, we can definitely perform more calculations here, like I just said, but with an isentropic efficiency value of 93%, we know that the real turbine process is going to move slightly to the right to get to 4. We can safely assume that the isentropic efficiency is high enough for 4 to still be located inside the dome, on the same pressure line, which means that the temperature at 4 is the saturation temperature we found earlier. And this is the TS diagram. Not particularly to scale, mind you. If you want to check out other Rankine cycle examples, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below. You'll also find the links to the other lectures of the thermo course, as well as other engineering courses playlists. Thanks for watching!